So we're here today with Gregory Kucera, who is a city council person for Clawson, who's seeking reelection, right?
Yes, correct.
Why are you running for office again?
This is my first term. I'm just finishing up 4 years of the first term, and I've enjoyed it. I think I've been helpful to the city. It's kind of in my blood because my father spent like 3 terms on the city council back in the 50s. He had a small business in town, a little dairy bar, and I grew up in town. I was raised here and spent all my life here in Clawson. I worked at the restaurant there, and then my father was a businessman, so I watched it from a business perspective. And I watched the city when he was on council, what things were going on then. I've seen a lot of the changes over the since the 50s in town.
What are some of those changes that you've noticed?
Back in the 50s, we had no on-street parking, and there was a big stink when they tried to put in on-street parking. Then they tried angle parking. People were upset for a while. Then they put in parking meters. I think that lasted about a year. They didn't take the parking meters out. They put concrete that they called decorations along the street. People didn't like that. Those came out several years later. The buildings were all old and original and quaint when I was a kid growing up, and then somewhere in the 50s and 60s they started decorating, putting aluminum siding on them, and now we're back to the stage where we're ripping all that siding off and we're going back to the original buildings.
So is that important to you, having that the original look and the historical stuff, or how do you feel about that?
I like it. I like the quaintness of it. It's unfortunate the way that Clawson was built. We're not built like other small cities. If I go to other small cities, their buildings are all packed. We have a lot of open spaces around here, and buildings are different heights. So it's a hard thing to architecturally design this city. We're lucky that we have the crossroads. We have 14 and Main. It's a good downtown location. We're solid on that, and we're doing the best we can. A lot of the buildings are being restored to their original consistency, and we have rules as what you can and can't paint and signage ordinances. We don't want signs all over the place, and I think we're doing a good job of it.
So do you think that, has the downtown grown in recent years, do you think? And what are some of the ways that you on council helps that kind of thing to happen?
Well, growth-wise, if you're talking about population, it changes constantly around town. You get an older crowd, and the older crowd goes away, and the younger crowd comes in. And people want different things, what I'm saying. Younger people want certain things, older people want something else. So as a council member, and as on council, that's what we do. We try to make the city good for everyone. That's why we did people approved the millage. We did a lot of work on the park here. Park's great for the kids. It's great for the kids and the families to get out there for sporting events. And then downtown, we put in crosswalks here. Some people don't like the crosswalk. We get a lot of complaints about it. I think it's just a new change we have to get used to. But a lot of the elderly people in town will find them very useful to get across. 14 miles of a 35 mile an hour zone. We're not like Rye Lork. We're not that slow. The slowing down traffic is, I think, a good idea. People just will adjust to it over time.
So when you ran 4 years ago, you talked a lot about business development.
Sure.
What are some of the things that you and your fellow council members have done in the past 4 years to work on that?
Well, several years ago, Clawson had a reputation as being business unfriendly, and none of us liked that. So we all got together on council, and we sat down. We're trying to streamline the process. So if you're a business and you want to come into Clawson, you can come in on a Thursday morning and you can sit down with everybody at one round table. You sit down with the builders, the inspectors, electricians. Everybody will meet with you and everybody will tell you what you have to do to open a business. You have to keep running back and forth. And I think that's helped out a lot of business. I get streamlined a lot of it. And we've hired a new person to encourage business to come into town. And we're growing now. We've got several new businesses going in. We still have some openings, spots in town, but we're filling them up.
So you grew up here because your dad was on council and had a business here. Can you talk a little bit about your background?
You know, this is the house that I was raised in, so I'm happy to live in it. I'm in the heart of downtown. I'm right off of 14 and Main. Everybody knows who I am, where I'm at. And if they want to stop and talk to me while I'm mowing the lawn or doing some yard work, they occasionally do that, so I talk to everybody. I graduated from Clawson High School in 1966. I got drafted into the Army about 67, spent my tour of duty in Vietnam, got out in 69, spent a short time living out in an apartment in Troy, spent a year maybe in Rochester, and then bought my first house here in Clawson in the 80s over on Bowman, and lived there very happily until I moved over here. I never was one for joining organizations, but the guys kept hounding me. And they got me, excuse me, joined the Clawson Lions Club. And within 2 years, I was president of the Clawson Lions Club. I'm still a member of that. I'm a member of the Eagles in town and the American Legion. I think they're all worthwhile endeavors. So any free time I have, I try to do some good with it.
Nice. And what is your professional background?
I used to work in advertising as a technical illustrator. So I worked on a drawing board, pen and ink. And I was pretty much self-employed almost all my life. I would freelance for companies, move around here and there.
Yes. And what? How does that background help you on council? What are some of the skills you bring from your professional life and your volunteering life to council?
I think, I don't know if it comes from any background thing. I'm just an extremely patient person. And I think one of my best features is that I will listen to everybody. I like to listen and listen and listen before I make an opinion on something. I don't jump into something full on right away.
Now, if you're reelected, are there any particular issues or goals that you have for the next few years?
It'd be the same thing as attracting more business into town. Clawson's doing really well, and we want business. We don't want a lot of bars. That's pretty much an agreement with all of us on council right now. But the more restaurants we can get and the more shops we can get, we need to build more business up in town, because when you have business, you have taxes. Clawson's always been considered a bedroom community. We have a lot of residents, and our taxes are high because of that. Other cities have big industries. We don't have room for industry in Clawson, but we have plenty of room for business.
Is there any challenges facing Clawson right now, or any issues that are contentious, or are things pretty good here?
everything's pretty good. Nobody's really complaining. We have council meetings, and sometimes there's only one or two people show up. I've gone to other meetings where they're packed housing on problems. We don't have complaints or problems around here. If people have any problems, they come to our council and in front of us, and we do our best to solve the problem for them. We talk to people. We're attentive to people.
So this will be your second term that you're running for, right? And there are three people running for two open seats, correct?
Correct.
Why should people pick you for the job?
Experience is probably the best I can give you, the best answer out of that. That took me a while, like the first year, sitting on council to figure things out and to watch what's going on. When you're an outsider, you're not aware of what the budget materials are. Once you get into it, you get your feet wet, you find it's running the city is like running a household. You have X amount of dollars coming in, X amount of dollars you can put out. So it's a decision-making process where that money goes. To us, and to me personally, we want to keep Clawson safe and secure. So we try to direct a lot of money towards our fire department and to our police department. And if those guys need help with anything, we try to help them out the best we can.
Is there anything that surprised you being on council? That you learned, like, once you got on there that you didn't know about before?
Nothing really shocking, no.
And how much work is it?
Well, what you see on the surface is two meetings a month.
Right.
But I attend those. I also, on my own, I go to the Planning Commission meetings, which are two meetings a month. If I can find the time for a zoning board, I go to that. I spent 6 years on the zoning board before I ran for city council. So I knew the background then. I went to all the council meetings then just to see what was going on. If people wanted to get a hold of me, you can go online with the City of Clawson. All of our council meetings are on video on demand. You can watch the meetings, or our address is on there. You can email me or anybody on council. Or you can stop by my office. I'm right here on 239 North Main Street in Clawson. Easy to find.